It has been a wild ride for the past 4 years for one man named LiAngelo Ball. In his debut, Jello has made it completely clear that he is on a mission to show everyone who ever doubted him why they made the biggest mistake ever by passing on him. This wild ride started in 2017 and it all came to a climax in the Charlotte Hornets' first summer league game of the season. For the first time in almost 3 years, the best shooter in the Ball family had a chance to gear up and compete in organized basketball. The icing on the cake being that this also happens to be in the NBA Summer League, something he was deprived of for multiple years. Now we have finally got a chance to see him play, and he did not disappoint. This man's level of play was off the charts, had the fans in the arena chanting his name. Having never played an NBA game and to see the adoration from fans and that crowd going wild as he knocks down triple after triple, all the way up to the second highest number of points on the Hornets team while playing the second least amount of minutes. They all thought his numbers were too good to be true in Chino Hills. They thought LiAngelo was just jacking up shots in the JBA. But on the court last night, the middle ball brother showed everyone that criticized his game why there is no doubt that he is 100% an NBA caliber player. Now, you guys likely all know LiAngelo's history, as he had a tumultuous journey after high school. He was pulled out of UCLA his first year for some silly mistake he made following some friends on his team. Jello was pulled out of UCLA shortly after, signed with Priyanai in the Lithuanian League, and declared for the NBA draft of 2018. What LiAngelo didn't know at the time was that he was essentially blacklisted. Expecting to be drafted by the Lakers in the second round, they instead chose Svi Mihailuk. When he thought his chances were going to be the Phoenix Suns, nope, they didn't want him. You'd think he still had a chance with the rest of the undrafted players, but nope, not even with his older brother Lonzo on the Lakers, he didn't even get a chance at a summer league game back then, and due to his nagging injury, Jello was about to go on the wildest ride of a lifetime. After being snubbed by the Lakers and the Suns, Jello went to play for LeVar's Junior Basketball Association with LaMelo, where the two went on to dominate and win the overall league championships. Following the championships, a European tour was up next where the two led a squad of JBA All-Stars against international teams across Europe for a total of 17 games, winning a total of 15. Now we know that LiAngelo is a talented player, but for the following 3 years, he went from killing it in the JBA in late 2018 to trying to get into the G League, which didn't really pan out, to rehabbing in 2019 from an ankle injury. Late 2019, he made the G League roster finally for OKC Blue as a practice player and was about to have his first game on March 13, 2020 when the whole NBA operation got shut down due to COVID. Following that, it seemed Jello lost his chances to play in the league. At this point, he had gone a year and a half without organized basketball and the sport was in limbo as G League was also canceled the following year. Jello did receive an offer slash invite to play for the London Lions at this point, but he did not see how this would help him in his goal of playing in the NBA. The London Lions is a much lower tier league and could easily be dismissed as another stat padding attempt, the same way many viewed LeVar's JBA. After turning down the offer, LiAngelo kept working and at the end of 2020 was invited to training camp with the Pistons on a 10-day contract. As you all know, he had been working out with Jermaine Jackson as well as LaMelo Ball, and with Jackson's hometown being Detroit, he has contacts. Jello was always in the gym, and if you put two and two together, you could see how a route was created for LiAngelo to get an opportunity. Issues cropped up, however, again, as it seems LiAngelo was suffering from some kind of injury and didn't even get an opportunity in any of the preseason games. All the fans got to see were a couple of footages from AB the Hero, who's been the top man for media regarding the Ball family. That was also brought courtesy of DKM, whom, if you're watching this video, you likely are familiar with his channel. He's been keeping Jello fans updated on all the latest happenings on the kid. Following Jello's departure from the Pistons, his window of opportunity kept getting slimmer and slimmer, as was LiAngelo. He kept working out, and we'd get updates in bits and pieces of how he's lost weight and put on muscle, and that he's still in the gym working on his game despite not having any real promise of being able to enter and play in the NBA. With LaMelo starting to turn things up with the Hornets at the beginning of 2021 and Lonzo going off for the Pelicans with a much improved shooting performance this year, People started wondering if Jello actually will get a chance to showcase his talent. He put his name in the pool for the G League draft, and with over 180 players in the pool and no more than 50 being selected, it was a slim chance that he would be a part of it. After the G League draft was held and LiAngelo's name wasn't called, it was back to the drawing board. The 2020-2021 NBA season came to a close, and LaMelo, after having sustained a wrist injury, came back and did just enough to be able to deservedly win the Rookie of the Year award over Anthony Edwards and Tyrese Halliburton. Soon after this, Jello was rumored as possibly being a Charlotte Hornet. He was working out with Melo, of course, as Melo had access to the facility. This enabled him to get in front of LaMelo's coaches and teammates, which provided the best opportunity for LiAngelo to be able to show what he's capable of doing. Jello was slated to play in the Drew League this summer, and when he didn't show up for the first game that had the big baller brand Drew League team appearing, eyebrows were raised. Reports surfaced showing LeVar's pops letting us know that Jello was not going to be playing in the Drew League because he was trying to get a deal done to join LaMelo in Charlotte. Jello was meeting with members of the front office, and though these guys wouldn't cop to it, it was clear that they were impressed with what LiAngelo was doing behind the scenes. For fans like us, we were dying to get some footage. Any footage of LiAngelo Ball holding his own, as the Hornets coaches put it, against NBA level talent. If you know how badly LiAngelo was trash-talked all across the media, then you'd understand how much it meant to see him actually play against this level of talent. A week ago, Jello was confirmed as being officially part of the Hornets Summer League roster, and in last night's game, it all finally came together. LiAngelo Ball had his first organized basketball game in almost 3 years against NBA level competition, and not only did he hold his own, he was one of the better performers on the floor last night. LiAngelo dropped 5 threes, including a 4-point play on which he converted for a total of 16 points on 5-for-10 shooting. That's 50% from beyond the arc in his first game back without shaking off any rust in a total of 16 minutes of playing time. I've said this man can score and more than qualifies to play in the G League and deserved a shot to be in the NBA. As a Warriors fan, I've shared multiple posts asking for him to get even a 10-day contract. Again, being blacklisted, Jello never got the opportunity there. I've been saying this for years at this point. It is a well-known fact that LiAngelo brings a crowd behind him wherever he goes. This guy is money on the court or off. A ton of GMs could have fixed their bottom lines with the Ball Show if they chose, but they all opted out. Now, Jello did have a workout with the Warriors prior to this draft, but his nagging ankle injury negatively impacted his performance. With the number of guys the Warriors have put on the floor who couldn't make a roster anywhere else, LiAngelo certainly would have helped the team out, knocking down 50% of his attempts. We've all seen what Michael Mulder did out there on the court last year, and Mulder is not the shooter that LiAngelo Ball is. This is the media narrative, however. That narrative is to lambast the Ball family, ostracize the kids, and shut up their loud, overreaching dad. You guys are well aware LeVar is banned from ESPN because Jalen Rose's wife had a dirty mind and decided to take offense to something that wasn't even meant in that capacity. Oh well, I'm sure ESPN would die to have some of those interviews with LeVar, so it will be very interesting to see how this plays out. Jello is well deserving of a roster spot, and you can bet that if he shoots lights out like this in another Hornets game, it will be very difficult to not sign him onto the 12-man roster. His movement off the ball was impressive and didn't seem slow and bulky as others would have you believe. He had no trouble keeping up defensively, although having the assignment of guarding Blakeney in the first game was very tough. LiAngelo moved the ball well, picking up 2 assists. He had 2 steals and pulled down 2 rebounds as well. That is a stat line that he can be very proud of, that all his supporters can point to and say, "See, I told you so." Jello, welcome to the NBA. By the way, don't forget to hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and hit that notification bell for more video coverage of this young man as he gets his career off the ground. Till next time. Swish.
KD the shit cock, word I'm a player, the real player. I don't give a prayer, man, fuck a naysayer. I block so hard, sweetie, get served. Call me Lonzo Ball, bitches get swerved.